Am I tall enough to see over the podium? That's going to be the question of the night. How is everybody? You know, it's so cool to be invited to be here tonight, to be a part of a ceremony that's going to honor the two greatest wrestling announcers of all time, who just so happen to be here in our presence tonight, Lance Russell and Dave Brown. And what a perfect venue to be here at Jerry Lawler's Hall of Fame Bar and Grill. As I look around, you know, you see this stuff, like here's Lawler and Kaufman, there's championship belts. If you take the time to walk around this venue, this restaurant, we can think about the memorabilia. And if that memorabilia could talk, the stories that it could tell. I know a lot of people spend time watching Memphis wrestling. If you watched Memphis wrestling when you were younger with your family, let me hear you. You know, it's cool, Memphis wrestling was not just something you watched on television. It was something that meant something to a lot of people. It was a passion point. It was something that you would do with your brothers and sisters, with your parents, and with your grandparents. And we saw some of the greatest stars ever that became legends right here in Memphis, Tennessee. Guys like Jerry the King Lawler. Guys like the superstar Bill Dundee. The Mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart. Handsome Jimmy Valiant, the Universal Heartthrob Austin Idol, Jerry Jarrett, Tojo Yamamoto, Jeff Jarrett, the Gilbert family. We saw these superstars every Saturday morning on Channel 13 or on Channel 5. They were a part of our lives, and we are so lucky to be able to say that. And then we saw some of the greatest superstars who went on to become worldwide stars, who started in Memphis and got to start on live television. Guys like Stone Cold Steve Austin started here in Memphis. Guys like The Undertaker started in Memphis. And what about The Rock? He started here in Memphis. And meant a whole lot to a lot of people. There was a constant, though, in a day and age where we watch television shows and they shuffle the announcers, and we never know who's going to be doing the commentary, and we never know who's going to be there, who's going to be hosting the show. When you think about Memphis wrestling, you could count on two guys that you wanted to welcome into your homes, two guys that you would invite to your Thanksgiving dinner. I'm talking about Lance Russell and Dave Brown. And ladies and gentlemen, they are here tonight at Jerry Lawler's Hall of Fame Bar and Grill. Please make welcome the greatest wrestling announce duo of all time, Lance Russell and Dave Brown. They mentioned when I moved to Memphis, I was 18 years old. I was just a kid who came from Dallas. And I'd never been on live television before. I had to put my career and my trust into two guys who are sitting right here, Lance Russell and Dave Brown. And those guys were able to take so many young people like myself and carry them through interviews to make them come across so much better on television. So guys, thank you for helping to make my career in Memphis, Tennessee. I appreciate that. I remember one time in 1995, I was cutting an interview, and I was trying to be cutting edge, and I remember saying on television that Lance Russell back in 1995 was an old fart. And I remember after that, after the show was over, Lance and Dave called me to an office, and in 1995 they said there was no way we could say fart on TV5 Wrestling. That's a true story. As I'm here to honor these guys, we have other legends here tonight. There was one person who wanted to be here who wasn't able to make it tonight, but he did want to send a video message to both Lance and Dave. Please turn your attention to the video screen, ladies and gentlemen. For Coco, beware. All right, we'll go back to Coco, beware. That was Coco. You never know what's going to happen. It's like the old days of live television, man. You never really know what was going to happen. At this point, I'd like to bring out the director of operations for this restaurant, Jerry Lawler's Hall of Fame Bar and Grill. He is a man who bleeds Memphis wrestling. He's from the same town that I do a morning show in, Jonesboro, Arkansas. Please welcome the former owner and founder and president of Power Pro Wrestling, Mr. Randy Hales. Says a person that bleeds Memphis wrestling. I also bleed this restaurant. Thanks for supporting us, and thanks for supporting the two greatest wrestling announcers of all time, Lance Russell and Dave Brown. Trying to get over here so I can get close, because basically this place is full and we appreciate it. Old wrestling promoter, when you got them hanging from the rafters, that's what you want to do. But I want to tell you a story, guys, and I might not have ever told you to this. I want to tell you that, believe it or not, before I was about 10 years old, I was a normal person. I know Brandon can't get that. You probably don't get it, and certainly the people who work with me every day has never seen me normal. But I was normal. Typical kid, but one Saturday morning, I was watching television, watching cartoons, and then the show went off the air. The cartoon went off the air, and then all of a sudden, I'm not going to sing for you, but I'm going to do this for you. It was on Channel 13, ABC television at the time, and after the cartoon, all of a sudden, here comes a jingle. Remember when TV did jingles? Lance, you can sing this with me. Here's what they said. It's America's favorite sport. On WHBQ television. Then after that, all of a sudden a two shot, a wide shot of Lance Russell and Dave Brown. And a voice I heard every Saturday morning for the next 40 years at home, and then from the control room once I got in the wrestling business, all of a sudden you heard this. Hello again, everybody. Lance Russell and Dave Brown right along ringside, all ready to go with another Saturday morning of studio wrestling. How about it today, Davey? Do you guys remember that? Do you guys grow up on that? So do I. Well, let me tell you something. I got a dream. A dream at that time. And everybody said I couldn't do it. Everybody said it wasn't in me. My dream, because I bled Memphis wrestling, I loved it more than anything, I was obsessed. I wanted to be the next Dave Brown. I wanted to be the next Lance Russell. But guess what? I would have been the following, greatest there's ever been. I wasn't good enough. But that's okay, because other people liked me, and I became a promoter and a matchmaker and got to hang out with my heroes like Bill Dundee and Jerry Lawler. Still today, Brandon Baxter and, of course, Lance Russell and Dave Brown. But I wanted to tell you, you know about the wrestling Lance Russell and the wrestling Dave Brown. Tell me anywhere, Google, encyclopedia, whatever, anybody in this building, tell me that you can find anybody that says one bad thing about Lance Russell or any bad thing about Dave Brown. They don't exist. These are two high-class, upstanding, great people. I'm telling you that. And you don't understand the young people in this room, my employees. You don't understand, because all you see now is WWE. And you see sports entertainment. But this was local. This was Memphis. And this was the greatest of all time. And the reason it was the greatest of all time is because you had two honest people. They believed. They cared about the product. They cared about their audience. And you could believe in them.
And that's why this place is packed tonight, because not only are you family to me and him and Bill and Dougie, you're family, and I hope you know this. I mean, I really hope this isn't the fact that after 50 years that this place is jammed, it was because the two of you came in our homes and was family. Am I right, people? Lance, no offense to you, but Lance, hello again, everybody. I mean, the greatest ever. Dave Brown will be the first to tell you. Taught me how to ring announce, taught me how to commentate, and even though it wasn't meant to be, it was meant to be for me to promote wrestling, and I learned more about wrestling from sitting beside him of what an audience needs to hear and want than anything. So you helped me to be the wrestling guy I was, and I love you for it, Lance, and have for a long time. And let me tell you something about Dave, and of course, Dave's two daughters and wife Margaret is here. Let's give them a hand. Carmen and Denise, and of course, Margaret, and your grandson Jared is here. I don't know where he is, but he's here tonight. But let me tell you something. I would be the one, because you know I'm obsessed with wrestling. Wrestling's everything to me, and you were great at it. But what a better, let's raise the level, not just about wrestling, not just about wrestling. Dave Brown, for four decades, starting at Channel 13, then for how many years at Channel 5 during the weather, 39 years, this man saved lives. There's five stations for people to watch. The reason they turned to Channel 5 in a storm, you did it and I did it on trip, is because you're trustworthy. The people trust you, we trust you, the whole entire town did. So we appreciate it. This man saved lives. And now I don't mean to upset anybody for this, but I have to say this, and I told you this is where I'm going to cry. You've seen a lot of wrestlers, Big Bad John and Kamala and all these giants, Andre the Giants and everybody. The toughest son of a gun I've ever seen in my life is Dave Brown. Dave Brown is Mr. Nice Guy, but when there's a fight to fight and the fight's right, Dave will fight harder than anything. He had a situation, and I'm sorry guys, but I just have to make this point. Had a situation in his personal life in 1998 where the worst possible thing that could happen to a family happened. The worst possible thing that happened could happen. But did Dave Brown, and he being the man, the leader of the family, if he would have faltered, if he would have fallen apart, you guys would too. And everybody else would. Some people know what I'm talking about, some people don't. But what did Dave Brown do? He fought every day, every day, every day, and he made dang sure the state of Tennessee, if you're caught drunk driving, by God, if you injure somebody or kill somebody driving, you'll be in prison for a long time. And the reason that happened is because you fought that fight, and this needed to be said. Getting heavy now. But this is a fun night. This is a night for tribute. A night to honor. And we'll see if we have that video. We'll go with that. If not, we'll go to the next thing. I'll let you know that. We're about to go, Logan, to see if we can do that video. But anyway, on behalf of King Jerry Lawler's, and I will speak in a little bit later about that, some special stuff, and we have a special video from Jerry if we can get the thing working. But I love you guys. Thank you, everybody. Thank you, Les Russell and Dave Brown.
To be in this building, to have the king, you had to have a superstar. And ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage the superstar, Bill Dundee. Thank you.
thing on.
Hey, Randy Hales, we can't say nothing. You said it all. I swear to God we can't. But I can tell you this much. In 1975, another gentleman from Australia named George Barnes and I got off an airplane in Nashville. We went up to Jerry Jarrett's house. And he said, Saturday morning, you're going to be at Memphis TV. I said, Memphis TV, where's that? He said, that's where Elvis lives. I said, okay, but how do we get there? He said, by car. I said, well, we don't have a car. Said, we better buy one. So we had to go out and buy this Ford 500. Not every one of us had drove on the left-hand side of the road. So I said, George, you want to drive this thing? He said, nope. I said, well, I guess I got to drive it. I said, what's in that box? He said, 24 little beers about this big. I said, well, what are we going to do with them? He said, we're going to drink them on the way to Memphis. I said, well, okay. He said, we're on the wrong side of the road. So we get down here, and I couldn't say, how are you doing with whatever? I just was nervous back then. But George talked pretty good, and Lance and Dave were the two announcers. So Mr. Russell tried to put an interview out of Bill, and it never quite worked. George did pretty good, and Dave did the same thing, you know. So they weren't, may not be, know all the holds and all the, you know, the counters and all the other things. Gordon Solie was very good at that, but his shortcomings were, he had a few too, but them two right there could get an interview out of a guy that couldn't talk, and I'm one of them guys that did that. So they persevered, and I persevered, and in the end we ended up with a pretty good team, I guess. Dave and Lance and Bill tried to tell you to buy a ticket on Monday nights, and you all bought tickets on Monday night, so we had to be doing a good job. So I thank both of you, Mr. Lance Russell, Mr. Dave Brown, I thank you. And the only bad thing about this is, you don't do this till you start getting older, and we're all a little older. Dave may not be as old as Lance and I, but I'm 90, but we're getting there. And Lance sure is, and it's just good to see you, brother. I just hope at 90 I can do what you're doing right now. I hope somebody invites me to a wrestling hall of fame or whatever it is. So you two is getting inducted into that. I can't think of any two other people that deserve it more. And I appreciate the help you gave Bill Superstar Dundee on his way up since 1975 until now. And I'm just glad I got to know both of you. Thank you all very much. And I'm not too sure about you. When I met you, you had long blonde hair. What happened to you? Mine's still black. It should be like Dave's, but I can tell you how you get this.
The superstar, Bill Dundee. At this point, we mentioned the families. You know, you think about the Dundee family. You had Bill Dundee. You had JC Ice Baby. We won't talk about him. We had Jerry Lawler and his crew. And we also had the Gilbert family.
Oh yeah.
You think about Tommy Gilbert and the early days with Jerry Jarrett and with Tojo Yamamoto and with Billy Wicks and with the fabulous Jackie Fargo. And then you think about Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert and the crazy things that happened with Eddie and Jerry the King Lawler. Who remembers Eddie Gilbert running over Jerry Lawler with the car on Channel 5? And after that we had Eddie's younger brother, who, man, he wanted to be ornery and he wanted to be crazy and he wanted to stir him up, and he still fights Jerry Lawler to this day. And he is here tonight. Please welcome to the stage, Dangerous Doug Gilbert!
Come behind Randy Bentley Hills and the superstar Bill Dundee, there's really not a whole lot to say unless you're myself. But what I want to do first of all is thank Randy for telling me this was happening tonight, because Lance and Dave, I think everybody in here knows that my dad was Tommy Gilbert, like Brandon said, my brother was Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert. And like I said, sometimes people in here might not want to know who I am, but I'm dangerous stuck here. But anyway, I was in Dallas yesterday playing a golf tournament, and a man kept popping up on my mind. And that man was Lance Russell. Now, everybody thinks all these big wrestlers and big athletes, they go do all these sporting events and, you know, they beat everybody. So, Lance, myself, actually, believe it or not, I think Jerry Lawler was with us a time or two maybe, or a whole ahead of us, so there wasn't no clubs broke. But there's a few of us wrestlers there, and I was playing the foursome with Lance. And I was playing golf yesterday, and Lance got popped up in my mind.
Can you make it work?
Lance Russell had one of the best sayings, and when he said it to me, I looked at him, I thought, Lance, what are you saying here? He'd say, Doug, we get up there, and Brian Christopher, he's out there with us. His muscles about as big as all of our heads. And he'd swing the golf club about 100 miles an hour. And Lance's saying was, Doug, y'all swing hard as you want, but my saying is not very far, but I know where I are. Lance's saying was, he might not drive it 200 yards or hit it 200 yards, but he'd hit it 100, 150 yards, but wherever he hit it, he knew right where it was gonna land. And now all these big athletes, we're out there and we're thinking, or I was thinking the first time I played with Lance, I thought, well, I've heard Lance pretty good, but surely maybe we can beat him. Lance beat everybody I ever played golf with. And I said, Lance, do you think you can show me how you play golf? I said, because you can see by the way I play, it don't look very well. And as far as families, like they said, you say the Lawler family, the Dundee family, the Gilbert family, the Funk family, the Briscoe family, Lance Russell and Dave Brown made every one of us. I mean, people always say, well, it's the wrestlers, and I go all over the country, and I've never seen two announcers that made guys more than Lance Russell and Dave Brown. And I'm not just talking about in the South, I'm talking about all over the world. Now, as a kid growing up, I don't think many kids got to do this. When I was 5 years old going to kindergarten, I got to go to the Mid-South Coliseum every Monday night. I got to go to the Coliseum there was one rule that my dad and my mom had. As long as Tuesday morning, you'll get up and go to school and you don't raise Cain and whine and cry, you can go to the Coliseum on Monday night. So I got to go to the Coliseum because I knew no matter how late it was we got in, which it'd be 1 o'clock, 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock in the morning, I don't care how tired I was, like I said, I was 5 years old, but I wouldn't go whine because I wouldn't get to go to the Mid-South Coliseum the next Monday night. But then, there's one thing that I can say that I know no other kid 5 years old got to do. Now, I know Lance didn't get paid for this, and he should have. But at 5 years old, I got to sit out at the Mid-South Coliseum with Lance Russell at the table right beside of him. And there's been a picture going around, and I saw it the other day. My brother actually took it. Now I'm 5 years old, and my feet don't even touch the floor. And here's Lance, and here I am. And I'm sitting. Me and Lance are both watching the match. Lance is doing his job commentating. But everybody else didn't know Lance was doing another job. He was babysitting. And I can honestly say, like we're talking about families, Lance Russell and Dave Brown, to me, are like my family. They're two of the best. Like I said, I think they're the best that they had ever been. Now, Lance and Dave, both of them give me a lot of good advice. And they told me a lot of stuff that I should do and a lot of stuff I shouldn't do. And I think a lot of you people in here know I didn't follow that, what I shouldn't do sometimes. But I apologize for that too. We all got to grow up sometime in life. But anyway, like I said, I was in Dallas and I'm not going to sit up here and rumble. But like I said, my dad, my brother, myself, Lance and Dave, all the guys that come through, everybody, all the fans think the wrestlers are what drew the crowds. Well, let me tell you something. It's not always the wrestlers what drew the crowds. It was these two guys sitting right here in the front row that drew a lot of the crowds. And I think everybody in here, I'll give them a big ovation right now. And I was sitting back there a while ago, so I don't want to do like what I said. I took one of the guys back there at the back table. I said, you know what? I will never get up behind the podium because Randy Hales is up there and he will ramble for an hour. But so Randy got done a little quicker than I thought. And what I want to say to everybody is there is not two better men as far as in wrestling or in this world than Lance Russell and Dave Brown. And on the last note, because Randy's probably back there saying, look, Bill, Doug's up there rambling. Hey, hold on a second. The only two people you heard and saw for 90 minutes was Lance Russell and Dave Brown on Saturday mornings. In my opinion, they are and they will never ever be another tandem as great as these two men. And that's where I should have finished, but look, they're going into the Hall of Fame as announcers, and that's great. But they ought to go in the Hall of Fame as announcers and legends because they are two legends.
Okay, Brandon.
Dangerous Doug Gilbert. All right. At this point, we do believe we have special words from Jerry the King Lawler on the screen over here. If you want to come up from the back as well. Here comes the king.
Lance Russell and Dave Brown, two of the favorite and most important people in my entire life. I mean, without you guys, there would be no King Jerry Lawler. No doubt about that. Just wanted to say, wish I could have been there, but I'll see you guys shortly. Congratulations, and be recognized for all that you have done for Memphis Wrestling. You guys are Memphis Wrestling, and you're the voices of so many people's childhood growing up watching wrestling there in Memphis. And I want to introduce right now another voice of wrestling that wants to say a few words for you guys.
All right, Lance and Dave, going to be a big night for you guys. Jerry, I know you were crying your eyes out.
I know.
The fact that you couldn't be there, you'd love to be there. I would have loved to have been there. I did have a chance to visit the old Lions last year out at the Cauliflower Alley. What a guy. David, you're in great company tonight. Guys, it's all about you tonight. Have fun. Jerry, thank you.
Thank you, Meiji. Lance, Dave, we love you. We'll see you soon.
It's about time to honor the two guys that we are here to celebrate tonight. The two greatest announcers of all time. If I could have the superstar Bill Dundee and Dangerous Doug Gilbert back up to the stage. It's cool for all of us to have the chance to share our memories about these two, but it's even cooler that so many of you share those same memories and have talked to them about these memories throughout this evening.
gentlemen, at this time, please come to your feet for the greatest announced duo of all time, Lance Russell and Dave Brown. If we can step down this way. Dave, this is a very cool piece of memorabilia put together by Jerry the King Lawler, specifically for you. If you could read that top line for everybody.
Wow, it says, Dave, you and Lance made me the king. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Wow. You and Lance were Memphis Wrestling, not the wrestlers. Dave Brown, I owe you so much. Signed, the King, Jerry Lawler.
And Lance, for you, this says, if not for you, Lance, there would be no me. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Lance Russell, I love you. King, Jerry Lawler.
And you know, I have a couple of things from the store, and I wanted to present one of the most famous Dave Brown things ever. One of the most famous Dave Brown things. You remember Batman and the Sugar King?
I do.
I want to present you with that picture from the club. Yeah. And Lance Russell, this is going back from a Christmas show. We want to present you with this. A picture, and I want you to turn it around and show the people. Lawler and Lance switched roles. Lance was General Lance. Lawler was Lawler Lance with the microphone back in 1976, a classic thing. And now, Brandon, you get the honor right now as Bill and Doug will carry it through to make this official announcement and induction right now.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the newest inductees into the Memphis Wrestling Hall of Fame, Lance Russell and Dave Brown. They're being presented with plaques right now, honoring their time as icons not only of Memphis Wrestling, but of Memphis television in general. And ladies and gentlemen, as it has been mentioned numerous times here this evening, Lance Russell started that Channel 5 and Channel 13 wrestling show with a very famous saying. And we're going to pass this microphone over to Lance and allow him to do that one more time here on Beale Street in Memphis.
Hello, good everybody. Lance Russell and Dave Brown, right low and ringside, ready to go with Bill Dundee, etc. And we're here for on a big day. Thank you very much.
Great shows. Thank you all for watching. Thank you for your support over the years. I must say this, the greatest part about this night is being here with Lance Russell. A mentor, a friend for life, and you may or may not know, he just turned 91 years old, and we're just thrilled to have him in town here.
Mr.
Day,
I guess I get to give you this as your name on it. Assuming it belongs to you, right? And nobody deserves it more than you, and all them kind words that Lawler said and everybody else said goes for me too, and this is yours, mate. All right, brother. Appreciate you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Lance Russell and Dave Brown.